Welcome back to it. No. Wait. We gotta charge this shit up. We need some more hype for what we're talking about today. Welcome back to a certified yak session.
So certified it hurts.
Today's topic, bro. Top 5 drippiest.
I drip on your bitch like water. I splash on your bitch with the water.
Anime characters of all time. So get ready and grab your umbrella, cause we about to enter the splash zone. Play my.
Drip too hard, don't stand too close. You gon' fuck around and drown. Off this way, doing all these shows. I've been on the road, I don't care where I go, long as I get paid. Bad little fire, she been on my mind. Soon as I get back, she can stay.
Number 5. I don't think this man really needs an introduction. Zoro is just somebody. If you don't know him, you know him, you know what I'm saying? He gets lost in many places, but a clothing store is not one of them. Look at each one of these fits. You can't tell me he ain't got that shit on. Each one is better than the last. And honestly, I think Oda might be the manga version of Gordon Ramsay, because this man was cooking!
I said,
with each of these fits. Cooking! Alright, moving on to the next one. Number 4. This man holds a place, special place in my heart. Trunks from DBZ. Dragon Ball Z. I know. Whoa, wait. Hold on. I know he only had 3 to 4 outfits, but we all gotta admit, when every single one of them came out, he had the maximum amount of swagger. He might as well be called a black teen. Oh, God. Like, look at how he pulled up in his first appearance in the series.
What in the...
Hey, Krillin, look! Up there!
Let's break down the fit. Okay? We gotta talk about the shoes. First off, we gotta talk about the shoes. Come on out. The one of one Capsule Corp ones, straight heel on the bottom of his feet. Oh, there's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. And okay, moving up, the jeans with the car seat belt, straight flames, originality. And then we got the black undershirt, depending on which version of the anime you were watching. It was either black, blue, or white, I'm pretty sure. And then we got Tapion's sword.
If you don't know who Tapion is, you just gotta watch a movie to understand.
Right, and on his back. And last but not least, I skipped this for a reason, the cropped jean jacket. Cropped. I don't think you heard me the first time. The cropped jean jacket, Capsule Corp jean jacket. Come on up. Bulma absolutely cooked by making this jacket. I used to want this as a kid. Matter of fact, I still want this as a kid. Wait. Matter of fact, I still want this to this day.
To this day. To this day.
To this day. But also, he kind of cooked with the sand armor fit during the Cell Saga with the ponytail on the back. Like, woo! Fire! Fuego! Moving on to the next. Number 3. AKA Mr. Put That Shit On Himself. And I'm not even glazing with that one. CBR called him that. Don't shoot the messenger here. And this is also my list. CBR, that list was trash anyways. Like, but look at these fits, right? He was doing Toji before Toji even existed. Like, look at the bag on his back with this next one. The handles around the shoulders, that's cold. That's a I don't give a fuck bag. Absolutely heat. This one right here, it looks like he's about to go on an adventure. The best adventure of all time fighting monsters. Oh, wait. Who am I kidding? He already does that. He's up here so high, not just because of his fits that he has on, but this kid is only 13 to 14 years old. The amount of style that this kid possesses right now is crazy. With a couple more years and maybe a possible time skip, he might be a contender to the drippiest anime character of all time. On to the next one. Number 2.
I don't care if she's a girl or a baby or somebody's grandmother. I'll still knock her out.
Yusuke Urameshi. All I'm saying here with his, he ain't got nothing extravagant like the others. But his shit is just super simple and yet effective. Like, look at the fits. Look at these fits. I can guarantee you right now, you can probably make something like this right now. Besides the color. But it would still work. This is peak 90s aesthetic. Like, I don't know what it is, but they all were very sleek and fashionable. Like, he just possessed so much aura, like, on like, how he was rocking this bright green color jacket. And it just worked. He just didn't give a fuck. And that itself makes its own style of drip. He just didn't give a fuck.
And now, it's time for the honorable mentions. Jay Yule, Lookism. Bruno Bucciari, JoJo's. Hinata Hyuga from Naruto. Jinwoo from Solo Leveling. And last but not least, our closest one to making it to the list, Urza Scarlet. Gojo.
And for the number one pick, the number one, they need no introduction. Matter of fact, their theme music says it all. Play it real quick. That's right. Number one is no one other than Ichigo Kurosaki from Bleach. And I don't need to say any more. This man had a men's fashion catalog as his secondary Bankai.
Bankai! Vogue magazine.
Because look at these fits. Every single one of them was heat. Every single one. Have you ever seen a character, aside from somebody from Tokyo Revengers, make a school uniform look this drippy? This man Ichigo could be on the cover of a Vogue magazine. Let's not get me started on the manga covers. This motherfucker really had no bad dress day. He simply couldn't miss every single fit. That's including the rest of the cast. Honestly, I could have made a whole ranking video about the whole cast themselves. They could have took every single slot, every single honorable mention on this whole top five. Yeah, but anyways, every single one of these motherfuckers could dress. Bleach is fashion, Solo's your favorite versus best dress. Hakai, face ass. Like, it's done. I'm wrapping up the video right here, because if not, I'm going on a whole tangent about how the whole Bleach cast could dress, outdress everybody in that bitch. On. Speaking of Ace Way and T, bye. Yeah, I think it's time for me to go. Yeah. Say that I loved you, yeah. That I never did. Yeah, said I loved her, yeah. That I never did, yeah.